Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for joining me. My name is Teebor. Let's build a robot. Or more precisely, let's upgrade the existing robot. Let's make this thing a killer. So, let's see what we've got. Pretty much anything I add here is going to give it extra health. Laser damage. Yep, let's have an Automatron head then. Let's go. We're going to need some armor on here. Improve damage and energy resistance. Improve damage and energy resistance. Yeah. They all improve it. Okay, let's go for the bad one. Best one then. And what have we got next? It's also movement, health, health. I don't know. Robo brains would make it pretty big. Let's put a Sultron torso on there for now. We can always change this. And front armor, we want improved damage and energy resistance, increases energy damage and carrying capacity. Really? Increased stagger on melee targets, improves damage and energy resistance. Increases carrying capacity. Well, let's be honest, we're not going to be getting much melee with this thing. So let's cram that on there. Rear armor. I'll also go for the same all round. Miscellaneous torso mods. What is wrong with that dog? Let's see, damage resistance, stealth build, radiation coils, sensor array.
I know I'm not the only person here who's lost something. I just
hacking and lockpicking routine is going to be completely useless. Let's put a stealth build on there. Nope, not an exit station just yet. Right then, let's go left arm. Protectron arms are going to be slightly better, I think. Yep, so we'll stick with that. Right, we want to change this weapon. I don't want something short-ranged. Definitely don't want something melee. Could do a laser, maybe. And an automatic laser. That's pretty boring though. Nail gun. Automatic laser, scatter laser, sniper laser. Let's put a sniper laser on there. For that arm. And let's pop on some armor. He's got a better damage resist than me. And go for the right arm. Let's pop some armor on there just quickly whilst we're at it. And we want to replace this claw with something that fires a little bit more rapidly than a sniper. Scatter laser seems like a nice idea. I get a laser Gatling gun. May break when used. It's tempting. Don't do for the moment. I'm going to put a scattered laser on there. Bit of the old up close shotgun. Legs. Let's have a look for legs. What do we got? More health, less carry weight. We could.
Am I ever glad to see you? We could really use a hand.
Let's stick with the Protectron legs for the moment. Six factory armor on. Oh, wrong button. Bit of left leg armor, a little bit of right leg armor. What voice are we up? Male voice, we can change this. No, we'll stay with it. Actually, we'll stick with the male voice. Let's go for a paint job. Oh, I like that. Oh, the blues look nice. Greys, light blues, and then a little green, pink, red, white, yellow. I'm gonna go with one of these early blues. Aqua blue or blue? Let's just go with blue.
It's always fascinating watching you create. A pleasure to see you again, sir.
Hey, you're coming with me.
Understood. Please, lead on.
And Dogmeat can go to Sanctuary Hills.
Assisting with the destruction of my own kind. Is there something I can
help you with, sir? Here you go, Ada. The final radar beacon. I'll need that head back when you're done.
Of course. Shouldn't take but a moment. There you go. Still in one piece. I'm not sure why you want the head back. All we needed was its radar beacon. Besides, robo-brains are notorious for being, well, a real pain in the neck.
Okay, this is a bit more information about his robot.
What else
brains.
Do you know about them, Ada?
Quite simply, it's the first time General Atomics produced a successful union between organic matter and robotics. The brain is used both as a control unit and a data storage unit, which is far more efficient than using standard circuits. Unfortunately, there were a lot of programming issues with these robots, which caused them to be a bit, shall we say, unhinged. Hopefully, this particular robo-brain will have some of the answers that we've been seeking.
A union of organic matter and robotics? Sounds an awful lot like a synth.
Not at all. The RoboBrain was built with a very different design philosophy in mind. General Atomic's intent was to use the human brain to augment the robot's functions. Primarily, to accelerate the decision-making process. Free thought and individuality was never intended. These were expressly built like soldiers, to follow orders without question. The RoboBrain's unfortunate tendency towards violence and aggression should be considered more of a malfunction than a calculated decision.
Okay. Right, can we go and...
We still need it, Ada. I believe it can help us access the Mechanist's facility.
Of course. It makes perfect sense that the Mechanist would not only keep its location a closely guarded secret, but would secure it against intrusion as well. I'm terribly sorry. I hadn't considered that possibility at all. I'm afraid when it comes to assisting humans, I'm not doing very well lately.
Why would you say something like that?
Isn't it obvious? Ever since I let my friends die in that caravan, I feel like I've been failing in my duties. I chose the route we took the day we were attacked. Perhaps if I had selected an alternate route, they'd still be alive. Sometimes I wish that Jackson had programmed me with my personality mode set permanently to disabled.
You shouldn't think that way. Your personality helps you think creatively.
I appreciate what you're trying to do, but it's obvious that having my personality mode on is causing me to make mistakes. I promise I'll do my best to make sure it doesn't happen again. Now I've distracted you for long enough. I'll finish up my calculations while you deal with our new friend, Jezebel. Hopefully, she'll be able to grant us access to the Mechanist's facility and we can put an end to this nonsense once and for all.
Build a body for Jezebel. Okay. So we want to build a new robot.
Everything and seems to be proceeding according to plan, sir.
Slap Jezebel's head on there.
It's astounding how much we still have to discover out here.
And I'm actually going to leave you like that. For now. Until we know what the score is.
This body you selected for me isn't quite what I had envisioned, but it will have to suffice.
What kind of body were you expecting?
Considering I look like a junk bot that's been hastily welded together by an amateur, I'd say almost anything else would have been better. However, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised, given your limited skill set derived from your equally diminished intelligence.
Well, I was gonna connect your head to Liberty Prime's body, but I decided to do a little arts and crafts instead. Disappointed?
If you're attempting to use sarcasm as an intimidation tactic, I'm afraid you're wasting your time. Look, it's obvious we don't care for each other's company, which suits me just fine. So, why don't you ask me everything you wanted to know, and then I'll be on my way.
I like that Liberty Prime idea. I'm going to have to look and see if somebody's modded that, because I bet it's not in there as a basic thing. Oh, yes. That'd be awesome. Okay, right.
Tell me everything you know about the Mechanist.
Now there's a fascinating subject. The Mechanist. Amazingly adept at programming. A veritable genius with electronics. I'm not surprised you're interested. I've been dutifully carrying out the Mechanist's instructions to help the people of the Commonwealth for quite a long time.
Helping the people of the Commonwealth? You?
Absolutely. It's my primary directive. The Mechanist instructed me to seek out and help the people of the Commonwealth. By my calculations, the easiest way to help a human is simply to destroy it. There's no point in prolonging a laughably fragile life. It's the most efficient way to assist them. Any other effort to help tends to result in numerous complex side effects.
Oh, that's nice.
I don't think you understand the definition of help.
Help. To give or provide. What is necessary to accomplish a task or to satisfy a need. I'm doing exactly as I was instructed. Assisting a human to the best of my abilities only affords a 25% survival rate. That means there's a 75% chance that despite my efforts, the human I'm assisting will die from something beyond my control. Therefore, it's better to hasten the human's death and put them out of their likely chance of misery than to deplete my limited time. It's actually quite elementary, but given your minimal intellect, I suppose I shouldn't be surprised you don't understand.
And you're going to be a brain pate if you don't tell me how to access the Mechanist's facility.
There's no need to be rude. It's rather simple, really. In order to gain entry to the Mechanist's facility, you're going to need to outfit one of your robots with an MSAT modification. I'll upload the plans to your Pip-Boy device. There. I've fulfilled my portion of our agreement. Perhaps I'll remain here for a while and see how things resolve between yourself and the Mechanist. Purely for my own amusement, of course. I suspect you'll have quite a tale to tell once you return. But then again, I'd be surprised if you ever return at all.
I wonder how long my systems will endure these broken conditions.
Okay.
Haven't you already interfered enough? Go away.
I trust you completed your business with Jezebel. I hope she wasn't too difficult.
She's insane. Said she's killing people to save them.
That logic. They killed my friends to save them? Had Jezebel been in my care, I would have decommissioned her. I hope you at least learned how to gain access to the Mechanist.
Jezebel gave me the schematics for something called an MSAT. I'll need to install one on a robot.
A custom modification that acts as a key to the Mechanist facility. Very smart. In fact, chances are high the MSAT may be required for multiple access points, like a robot identification card. As for my task, I was able to decrypt the signal with the final radar beacon. The source is coming from a Robco sales and service center, most likely a front for a larger operation. It's time to take the offensive. Have you formulated a plan?
This Mechanist is a real threat. I only see one of us walking away from this one.
I won't disagree, but it may be beneficial to discover motive and reasoning first. Now, if you're ready, I believe you have an MSAT to install. Would you allow me to assist you on this mission?
No. Stay here.
I understand. I wouldn't want my own personal investment to cause any complications.
And I want to take my other robot with the big gun. Right, Automatron, we need
Jackson
to install.
Jackson ensured I was well-built for travel. His modification...
And then it's that.
...for quite some time.
You certainly know your way around a workbench.
Yeah, talk dirty to me. Weird robot. Okay, so what do we do now?
Hey.
What can I do for you?
I need to ask you something.
New orders, sir?
Haha, self-destruct. No.
You didn't have anything else.
All right.
My databanks are continuing to accumulate vast amounts.
Right, where to now then? Quests, restoring order, access the mechanist lair. The mechanist lair is Robco Sales and Service Center. Right next to the airport. Please let me have your Liberty Prime.
Any institutes fall, unless anyone would risk tampering with our humanity.
Are you coming, robot? Walking like that? Probably, yes. Alright, this way. Well, seems pretty quiet over here. Oh, that's disappointing. I thought we might at least kind of get one or two things to shoot at, maybe. No. Okay, well, let's just go into the Robco building then. Okay, it's got a bit of a long load time on this one. Oh, come on. Wow, this is really taking its time. This could give us a nice pretty picture or something to look at rather than a little logo in the corner. Here we go, right. What can we steal?
I'm glad my intakes have a dust filter.
That's nice for you. Random bits and stuff. Working, couple of working computers here. Let's see what's on these then, shall we? Okay, this is a nice little showroom. Fourth quarter reviews, budget meetings, dentist appointments, personal contacts, messages system, blah blah blah, Halloween. That is all going to be nonsense, aren't they? Moving on then. Thank you for the trip. Where? Thought that was a safe. Oh well. Interesting collections of rubbish. A locked computer with a locked safe nearby.
Got it.
Thank you very much. I suppose we might as well just unlock this as well, just to get a little bit of extra XP. Somewhat rusty at these. Yeah, thanks for removing the one that I just worked out was bad anyway. There's another one. Another one there. I thought that was one. Oh no, there's one there. And there's one. Stuff. Nothing I'm sure I'm going to find interesting in a safe control. Let's carry on then. Anybody down there? Where we're supposed to be going. Or at least part of where we're supposed to be going. Let's do a quick bit of looting before we carry on. How broken is a broken terminal? Because the ones upstairs are pretty broken. Please verify necessary hardware somewhere, blah blah blah. Turn it off and on again. A Rubco sales centre's. Handy. And, you're right up there, eh?
Over here.
How many doors do you need? Seven, eight, if you count that one at the other end of the tunnel. Stop the mechanist.
If we keep standing in this radiation,
you're going to... Incoming robot detected. Opening security doors.
Okay. doors on here as well. Wow, that is an impressive number of doors this guy has. Robot sounds like it's stuck. No, he's just being weird. It's all pretty uneventful so far. Well, if I don't count that. Apparently these are all friendly. Interesting. Except for that turret, of course. Goodies have you got in here? None. Oh, I love your iBot model though, thank you.
My systems are continuing to function at peak efficiency.
Good, I mean you're in the way. I love that. Now, we could go round, or we could go through. I'm thinking spare parts. Come on, target, thank you. Nothing interesting in there. This reminds me of that corridor with all the laser trip wires in it. Come on. Slightly awkward to target. Nice. Lots and lots of lovely crystals and optics. Now let's go see what's down this tunnel. Probably going to take us into this room, which it is. We could use the security office terminal to turn them off. Oh, okay, what's all this? It all seems to be locked down. Probably causes better be security for unintended operative. Wow, okay. Chief scientist should prepare a Mesmatron equipped robo brain to aid in the interrogation process. Spontaneous cranial eruption, lovely. Let's autopsy supervisor Gamma 9 security alert. Will initiate a maximum security lockdown in the research wing. And a minimal security lockdown elsewhere within the research wing. All security defensive systems will activate. All local and remote terminal functions will be disabled. Security doors will be sealed. Nice. Of confirmed nuclear detonations, facility administrator, or in his absence, the highest level supervisor on duty here after acting administration will institute a temporary lockdown. Okay, nice. All personnel pass through decontamination. Personnel must display rank 22 at minimum security badge, security photo ID. Failure will result in immediate security lockup. Guess we'll present a signed letter of approval. Wow. Let's hope I don't have to do all that. Why are you still milling around out there?
Sweet.
Arch control. Activate decontamination hodges. Turret control. Currently all offline. Yep. Security door control. Nope, we don't want to fiddle with any of those. An elevator. Interesting. Where does this elevator go?
Got it.
Elevator access to the control center is prohibited. Standing by for authorization. Damn it, damn it, damn it! Down there, knock yourself out. Excuse me. Well, he seems to work. It's so dark in here. Bobby pins, that's what I need when I've already got so many in the game, can't tell me how many I've got. Where'd the other robot go? Hold on a minute, oh there he is. I guess we are going this way.
Over here.
This guy has a serious fascination with doors. Locking ammo boxes. You're just wasting my time.
Nice.
Oh, I had hard ammo in it. You? Chin here. place. I'm not seeing much anyway. Oh, I'm about to see something. My robot's in there somewhere. Nope, it's broken. Ooh, that's got incendiary rounds in it. Right, well, I think we now know your limited amount of damage you can take. I might just give myself a little bit of a stim pack there. Oh, hello. Run, production control. Get things back on track. Took a while, finally managed to weed out the last of the general atomic ingrates from my department. Lazy bunch of people. Please report the department is back at 100% efficiency now that the section is staffed entirely by soldiers. Better get done on budget on time. See, then you got pylons smoking. What was this about? I caught hooking up the robo brain heads to one of our recompilers to try and have a conversation. How many of these things have you got in here? That's a lot of place to keep a spine in your desk, mate. So, are you going to activate? We've only got one robot here. Let's see if we can activate him.
There we go.
Turret control. Turret error, broken. Shot to pieces, more like. Choose personality mode. Law enforcement, I like the law enforcement one. Activate unit. You're actually pretty useless there, weren't you? Wait, are you actually... I know you are still apparently working. Alright. Now my flaming death robot. Head on through. Come on, guys, what have we got in here? Unfield kickball. I'll have that because I'll have everything. I can hear something. just can't see you. Oh, no. We've got a very good workbench we can work on.
If they're out there, we'll find them.
Hello. There's a lot of stuff here to look at. I love that. You could go in there, thank you very much, mate. It's not going to do you much good. I love your robot as well. And your microscope. Ooh, play that.
Lead engineer, Thomas Harkin. So far, we're tracking on schedule for the latest RoboBrain milestone. Dr. Asante has assured me that the active time between memory wipes has been greatly increased. Hopefully, that will hold true in our latest live testing. The senior engineers also informed me that their latest assembly line adjustments have been completed early. I can only hope that means due diligence was still paid, and we're not going to be looking at a total system breakdown again. Other than that, I'm still worried about the, test subjects. Right now, we've got more than enough to meet our demand. But it's not like these things grow on trees.
Looks like they've been having problems trying to get robo brains to work. Some of the robo brains are misinterpreting commands. The onboard brain seems to almost overthink these instructions, decide to rewrite them for the efficiency purposes. One of the brains rolled off line with a faulty voice module. When it speaks, it's speaking in reverse. This troubled me, so I had to shut down the line for almost 8 hours while I checked the software for issues. Then gave the auto output diagnostics, combined the issues, gave them all clear. To resume assembly and mark details of glitch. No idea what would cause such a ridiculous issue, but if you ask me, I think it was one of the guys upstairs thought it'd be funny. I think it's funny. Right, I'm gonna end this episode here. We're still randomly searching our way through this area. Had a little bit more information about the robo brains, a little bit more story background. So I think this is a good spot to stop, and I will see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe or you might miss it. See you soon. Bye bye.